So this is the question we have. It says, in which of the following pair of species the hybridization of underlined atoms is same? We have these options. Students, if I talk about BH3 and B2H6. Here the boron will have hybridization sp2. Here it will have hybridization sp3. SiO2 in solid state will give you tetrahedral structure in three dimensional network. So SiO2 will have three dimensional network structure. So silicon here will have sp3 hybridization. In case of CH4, the carbon will have hybridization sp3. Now, if I consider XeO2F2, the hybridization here is sp3d2, sp3d. Here, the hybridization is sp3d2. If we find the hybridization of carbon dioxide, carbon has hybridization sp, and SO2 in sulfur will have hybridization sp2. So, out of the given option, only option 2 has the correct answer. SiO2 has the hybridization sp3, CH4 has the hybridization sp3. So the correct answer for this question is option 2. Now let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. In sodium chloride sample, ions are held together by a characteristic type of force. This force is, R is the distance between the ions. First option, directly proportional to R square. Second option is inversely proportional to R square. Third option is directly proportional to R. And the fourth option, inversely proportional to R. Students, if I talk about the sodium chloride molecule or sodium chloride solid, it has sodium ion and chloride ion. These are attracted towards each other with strong electrostatic force of attraction. This is electrostatic force of attraction. So because of strong electrostatic force of attraction, we can simply say the Coulombic force or electrostatic force of attraction is inversely proportional to R square. It is directly proportional to the charges Q1 and Q2. Hence, the correct answer for this question is option 2. Now, let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, identify the incorrect statement according to the kinetic theory of gases. These are the options we have. First, particles of gas are in constant and random motion. Second, the collisions of the particles with the walls of the container are the cause of pressure exerted by the gas. Third, when the particles are close to each other, the attractive forces between them is proportional to R square. Fourth, collisions between gas molecules are perfectly elastic. Students, if I talk about kinetic theory of gases, it says that the molecules have negligible volume and they do not have any type of attractive forces between them. Hence, the third statement is incorrect and it is the answer for this question. Now let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, assuming ideal gas behavior, the amount of heat released and change in volume after mixing of two gases in a rigid container at same temperature respectively are. Students, if I talk about ideal gases, they do not have any type of intermolecular forces. So there will be no heat exchange or no heat released. Also, there will be no change in volume. The total volume will remain same, considering the pressure is same. Hence, there will be zero change in heat and zero change in volume. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option 3. Now, let's move to the next question. This is the next question we have. It says, consider the characteristic property of liquids called as surface tension. And check the following statement. Statement 1 says, it is due to the net attractive force on the bulk particles as compared to the surface particles. Students, if I talk about surface tension, it is a surface phenomena. Bulk particles will have net zero forces because they are attracted from all the directions. On the other hand, the surface particles will have net attraction force. So this statement is false. Next, it says liquids tend to rise in capillary due to surface tension. Students, because of the surface tension, liquids tend to rise in the capillary. Hence, this is the true statement. Third statement says its dimensions are same as that of pressure. Students, if I talk about the dimension of surface tension, or I should say the SI unit of surface tension, it is Newton per meter. While that of pressure, it is Newton per meter square. This is a wrong statement or false statement. Now the question says, which set of statement or statements are correct? So only statement 2 is correct, that is S2 only. Therefore, the correct answer for this question is option 3. Now let's move to the next question.